In this video, we're going to take a look at how we can add text and symbols to an Autodesk Inventor drawing. I'll start with text. I'll click on the Annotate tab, and here in the Text panel, we can select the Text tool. I can then either click a point to place my text, or I can click and drag to place a text box. If I click and drag, then that's going to allow me to have some text wrapping based upon the size of this box. Then inside the dialog box, you have a lot of standard tools for text editors: bullets, numbering, horizontal alignments, vertical alignments, spacing. We also have the ability to stretch the width of the text out here as well. We can change our font type. We can change our height. We can control color information as well as bold, italics, underline, and strike through. And we can do some fill color as well. So once again, a lot of standard tools that you're going to find in any text editor. Quite simply, we can go ahead and type in our text here. We also have the ability to access some common symbols here as well. And then, of course, I can click OK to place my text. To edit text, you just simply double click on it. In some cases, I need to highlight the text before making a change. For example, if I wanted to change the height, changing this to 6 doesn't do anything unless I highlight the text first and then make that change. Next to the text tool, we have the leader text tool. Here we can go ahead and click a point for my leader arrow and a second point. Then I can right click and continue. That's automatically going to create the little horizontal landing for me. And then once more, we can enter in our text note there. We also have access to several different symbols as well. Here in the Symbols panel, we have the Sketch Symbol tool if you've got some custom created sketch symbols. Otherwise, we have several different ones available to us from Autodesk Inventor. For example, if I'm putting in a surface texture symbol, I can click to place it. If I want a leader, I can go ahead and click additional points, or I can just right click and continue to just get the symbol. Then once again, I can enter in any values and make any other needed changes to the symbol as well. Similarly, I can place a welding symbol here. Once again, I'll right click and continue and adjust any values. So if I want a 1/4 inch fillet weld with carbon arc welding, I can add that information in. And there you can see my note. As you can see, I can click the drop down here and I have access to lots of other symbols, especially those related to geometric dimensioning and tolerancing, such as a feature control frame. Once again, I can enter in any information here to create my feature control frame. That concludes this look at placing text, leader text, and symbols in Autodesk Inventor drawings.